R&D. Like Champion DRDO, I spent a warm welcome to each and every one of you. Today is a significant day in the journey of the LCA Air Force Mark 1. Today marks the formal declaration of the final operation clearance by the Secretary of Defense R&D and Chairman DRDO, as well as the handing over of the final operation clearance certificate and release to service document to the Indian Air Force. We also have with us for the occasion the Chief of Air Staff, Indian Air Force, Chairman and Managing Director, HAL, CE Semilac, and the Director General, Aircraft Quality Assurance, amongst a host, Defence Secretary, and a host of other dignitaries from the past and the present. They've all kindly consented and taken the time to be with us for this event. Before I get to the formal event, I'll just cover very, very briefly how the journey of the LCA was to get where we are. The journey began with a need to replace the Indian Air Force's MiG-21 fleet. As a replacement, this aircraft had to don the role of a multi-role fighter in air defense as well as the ground attack role. Thus was conceived the LCA, a fourth generation plus fighter, incorporating all the contemporary technologies as well as meet IAF's weapon requirements, maneuverability and the multi-role status. The initial operation clearance was granted in December 2013. Initial operation clearance mainly involved avionics and sensor integration, air-to-air capability with close combat missiles, and air-to-ground capability with conventional weapons as well as with precision attack. The aircraft was also environmentally cleared for hot, cold and high altitude operations. The LSP aircraft participated well in IAF exercises Iron Fist 2013 and 2016. The IAF inducted IOC standard aircraft in July 2016 into the 45 Squadron Air Force, and it's a matter of pride that the aircraft has participated in the IAF exercise Gagan Shakti very well. They have flown over 1,500 sorties so far. After December 2013, final operations clearance got underway in real earnest, and some of the key capabilities that were added in final operation clearance was the air-to-air beyond visual range firing, air-to-air refueling capability, as well as air-to-ground bombs that were earmarked for final operation clearance. The flying envelope of the aircraft was also enhanced. The LCA FOC endeavor culminated in handing over the drawings applicable for the production of FOC standard aircraft to HAL in December 2018. The indigenous fighter aircraft, LCA Force Mark 1, is a handwork of multiple agencies: ADA, HAL, Semilac, NAL, ADE, and a large number of DRDO labs and private sectors who have contributed in no small measure. To get to the main part of the ceremony, I now request Secretary Defence R&D to declare FOC and give the certificate to the Chief of Air Staff, Chairman